So I will present briefly what we are trying to do on the side of renewable legislation. We have proposed a revision of the Renewable Energy Directive as part of this big package that was put on the table in July. My colleague will say a bit more, I'm sure, in a bit. But focusing here on the renewables part, the very first thing to keep in mind is why are we revising this now already? Because we had already worked very recently, actually, on the renewables directive, and actually the transposition period for member states was due in June this year. So we have a transposition period ending in June, and we are already revising in July. So why are we doing this? Well, it follows mainly from the higher climate ambition of this commission, as expressed in the Green Deal, and in particular the climate law that enshrines the principle of climate neutrality in Europe in 2050. From this, I think a lot of things logically followed. In particular, the climate target plan, which in a way is assessing what this ambition for 2050 means for 2030, what is the optimal trajectory. And the conclusion is that when it comes to GHG reductions, we want to accelerate and go to minus 55% in 2030 already. And that for the share of renewables, it means a fast increase. And reaching a share of 38 to 40%, so above the share that is in the current renewables directive. That's, let's say, for the overall level of ambition. When it comes to the measures and how this could be done, we also worked on a few strategies over the past months and years in the Commission, touching on several aspects of renewables policy. The first one to keep in mind is what we have called our energy system integration, together with the hydrogen strategy that tries to have a bit of a forward-looking perspective on the energy system of the future, if you want. And I will say a few words in the next slide on this. Second aspect to keep in mind is also as part of what we have called the renovation wave, a renewed focus on buildings and renovations, and that includes. It's not only about energy efficiency, it's also about the role that renewables can play there. Then also a new focus or a stronger focus rather on offshore renewables. And last but not least, we have worked on a new biodiversity strategy, which is highly relevant for renewables because higher renewables targets may mean increased pressure also on the biomass as regards its energy uses, and we need to make sure in a way that increased ambition does not translate into, let's say, more than necessary pressure leading to unsustainable use of biomass for energy purposes. That gives you a bit the context.
Sorry, Pierre, sorry to interrupt you, but we're still seeing the first slide. Apparently, you're not advanced. Oh, okay. So just to
Now
make
I'm
sure that
moving.
everything's correct.
No, it was correct. On this energy system integration strategy or vision, I think we've tried to clarify that there's nothing completely new in this. It's just a formalization of view for the energy system of the future, and it's based on three clear pillars. The first one is a more efficient and circular energy system. So we do underline the need to take up this notion of a more circular economy and to apply it also to the energy system through a better use of, in particular, waste streams for energy production. We can come back to this if you want. The second pillar is really deep electrification of the system based on renewable electricity. And the last pillar, which is meant as the last pillar, is really renewable and low carbon fuels in those sectors where essentially energy efficiency and circularity and electrification won't do the trick. Okay. How do we get there and what does it mean? It really means that we want to move, if you look at the upper side of the slide, we want to move from this linear, top-down energy system that we have today towards a much more complex system with much more complex flows and also new energy carriers. And I will give you a few numbers on this. Just to keep in mind the big picture when it comes to renewables, where are we in 2019? We are very close already in 2019 to our 2020 objective of 20%, just below. But the picture is quite differentiated, of course, depending on member states. That's what you see on the left, but also depending on the sectors. And we've made a lot more progress in electricity than in heating and cooling, and most importantly, than in transport, where progress has been slower to date. When we look into the future, and I have included here some of the main results from our projections as part of the climate target plan. A few big conclusions. The first one is that we will be in a world with fast declining demand under all scenarios, which you can see on the upper left side. Declining demand, but also a fast change in the energy sources that we use. Okay, this is what you see just below. In all scenarios, you see very fast growing renewable shares across all sectors. Electricity, heating and cooling, and transport. And you see a very strong increase in the electrification of demand. This what I stressed under this pillar two of the energy system of the future. Under all scenarios, we rely more on the use of electricity in new end use sectors. Okay. Overall, it gives you the renewable energy mix that you see on the right, on the right hand side. You see, unsurprisingly, when it comes to 2050, massive use of wind, both offshore and onshore.
Sorry to interrupt you, but we aren't seeing the slide. You're still on the first one, as I've tried to say.
Okay. Then it's okay. then I understand better your point. What are you seeing? You're seeing the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 small boxes, or?
Well, no, we're actually seeing just the first slide.
All right. Okay. Then I would. I can only invite your colleagues to try and share it yourselves. Otherwise, I will continue without the slides because this has reached the limits of my technical knowledge. On my side, I'm seeing myself as sharing my screen.
You can conclude your presentation without images. I think it's the easiest because you're already. Past due time, you have 3 minutes left. So if you can just explain without images, that's I really apologize for that. But
no worries. Then I mean, stemming from all that, quite logically, you will see where we focus in the update of the renewables directive. The first one obviously is that we want to increase the ambition. So we propose that instead of a 32% target in the current directive, this becomes at least 40%. Okay, so that's quite an additional effort to be reached at EU level. And then in terms of the measures, you will find a strong focus on greater energy system integration with measures promoting electrification, including in transport, and also the consumption of renewable hydrogen, in particular with dedicated targets for hydrogen. Then we're reviewing also some more sectoral measures and targets across the heating and cooling sector, district heating, and we're introducing also new forms of benchmarks in buildings and industry. And last but not least, we are revising and strengthening our bioenergy sustainability criteria, in particular when it comes to forest biomass, a bit in line with the biodiversity strategy. So this is really what I wanted to share, spending a bit of time on you know, what is the energy system of the future and how it has influenced in a way what we've been focusing on in the revision. And I leave it at that for questions.
Thank you.